Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge, and if you're new here, welcome to my channel. On this channel, we do Final Cut Pro tutorials, filming techniques, gear reviews, and similar videos to help you make better videos. Today, we'll learn how to add the picture-in-picture effect to your videos. Let's get started. The simplest way of adding a picture-in-picture effect is by using the Transform tool. Select the clip you want in your main window, and press E to add it to your timeline. Next, move your playhead to the start of your timeline, select the clip you want to see in the picture-in-picture window, and press Q to connect it above your main clip. Ripple trim this clip to the same length as your bottom clip. With the top clip selected, at the bottom of your viewer window, select the Transform tool. Grab one of the corner handles and drag in towards the center of the viewer window to resize it to the size you want. Click and drag on the middle handle to reposition this clip. Click Done. And just like that, you have a picture-in-picture in your project. You can also add a border to this window to make it stand out. Press Command-5 to open your effects browser. From the Stylize category, select a simple border effect and drag and drop it over your top clip. In the Video Inspector, you can change the color of this border, adjust the width of it, and even change the transparency of it by adjusting the mix slider. Nice and simple, and all done using the tools included with Final Cut Pro. The last method works great if you have a 16:9 picture-in-picture window and don't need to reframe the image inside this window. The next method we'll take a look at today gives you a little more control over the image inside your picture-in-picture window. Once again, add your main clip to your timeline and layer the clip you want inside your picture-in-picture window above this clip. Next, if you don't have one, go to my website and download and install an adjustment layer. I'll leave a link for it in the video description below. It's completely free. Open the Titles and Generators browser and add this adjustment layer above your top clip. Ripple trim it to the same length as your clips. In the Effects browser, select the Masks category and add a Shape Mask to this adjustment layer. Use the green handles to adjust the shape and size of this mask, the white handle to adjust the curvature, and click and drag the outside ring to adjust the feather of your mask. If you want nice sharp edges for this window, make sure the feather value in the inspector is 0. Use the white handle in the middle of this mask to move it to where you want your picture-in-picture window. Next, select the clip you want inside your picture-in-picture window and use the Transform tool to resize and reframe this clip. Click Done. And last, to be able to see your original clip you initially added, command-click your adjustment layer clip in the picture-in-picture clip and combine them into a compound clip with a keyboard shortcut Option-G. As you can see, this method gives you quite a bit more control over the size of your picture-in-picture window and the framing of the clip inside it. And if you need to make any adjustments, you can double-click the compound clip to go back into it and adjust the size of your mask or the framing of your clip as needed. After making all your adjustments, press the back arrow key in the bar above the timeline to go back to your project. And last, let's take a look at how to add a round picture-in-picture window with a border. We're going to achieve this by using one of Final Cut Pro's shape generators. Once again, add your main clip to your timeline and layer the clip you want to use inside the picture-in-picture window over it. Next, from the Titles and Generators browser, in your generators, select the Elements category, add a shape generator, and if necessary, ripple trim it to the same length as your clips. In the Generators Inspector, uncheck the Fill checkbox and adjust the appearance of your outline. Select the middle clip and use the Transform tool to reframe your clip inside the circle. Click Done. Select your generator clip, hold down the Option key, and drag straight up to make a copy of it. With your bottom generator clip selected, in the Generators Inspector, deselect Outline and select Fill. Go to the Video Inspector and from the Blend Mode drop-down menu, select Stencil Alpha. Command-click your three top clips and combine them all into a compound clip. Use the Transform tool to resize and reposition this picture-in-picture window. Click Done for this round picture-in-picture effect. If you enjoyed this video, let me know by hitting the like button or in the comments below. And if you haven't yet, make sure you hit that subscribe button for more videos just like this one. Thanks for watching. I'll see you back here next week.